So Illustrator has over 70 tools, and today we're going to look at 9 that will make drawing a million times easier. And first up, we have the pencil tool. So this chap might look familiar. Oof, look at that pixelation. Oof. So to redraw this, first we're going to select the pencil tool. Let's double click that tool to get more options, crank up the fidelity, and check these two boxes here. Now you can draw or trace over your design, and when you let go of the mouse, or in this case trackpad, you'll have a perfectly smooth line. And let's thicken this up so we can see what we're doing. That's much better. And you can also use this tool to click and drag over an existing path to reshape it. But that was rubbish, so let's undo it. Next up, the smooth tool. And this one is hiding under the pencil tool, and quite simply, you can use this to click and drag over a path to smooth it out. Now again, let's use the pencil tool to draw in some more of these lines, and just make sure after every line that you let go of the mouse or trackpad, because otherwise the fidelity we cranked up earlier is going to try and round off any sharp corners that you draw. Right, last one here with a trackpad. Oh, nearly got it. Oh, that was pretty good. Right, next up, the pencil. And this is a more advanced tool, but it's perfect for drawing smooth curves. Simply click and then click again and drag out a nice smooth curve. Right, next up, we have the shape tools, of which there are many. So let's click and hold. You can see a bunch here. I'm going to grab the ellipse tool, click and hold with shift to create a circle. And a cheeky shortcut is to drag with alter option to create a duplicate. And honestly, nothing fancy here. We're just using the ellipse tool to create circles and then duplicating them with that shortcut. Now let's go back to the pen tool, which can be used to draw dot to dot straight lines as well. If it does look like this, what you can do is select the eyedropper tool. Simply click on an existing stroke and it will copy the stroke properties. Next up, the scissors tool. So we're going to use this for the ear, but first of all, I'm just going to create a circle and then select this. It's hiding under the eraser tool, and we can use this to make a cut along a path. So let's make a couple of cuts here and then use the direct selection tool to select the path in between and hit delete to remove it. Right, now onto the shape builder tool. So let's drag over all of these lines to select them and then grab the shape builder tool here. And we can hold alter option and click, and we can use this to remove individual lines. And we can now use the pencil tool, the pen tool, whatever you like, to draw these other parts of the ear. Again, I missed a bit of his cheek here, whoops. So let's just use the pen tool to draw another curve in there, lovely. Another use for the shape builder tool is also to combine selected shapes together. And now we're gonna move on to the curvature tool, which is perfect if you find the pen tool hard. You can find it up here. Simply click and then click again to define the halfway point of a curve, and you can see it will assist you in drawing perfectly smooth curves. Very helpful indeed. And I did a video on this tool recently, so definitely check it out. Right, now let's use the shape builder tool with alter option to trim those ends. And next up, another way to use the direct selection tool. So let's select his chin neck area thing and press A for this tool. And we can click on these corner widgets and then drag to round off the corners. And again, this is a great technique if you find pen tooling hard. And you can see this bit of path wasn't quite connected, so I can use this tool to snap paths together as well. Now I'm going to unlock the original pixelated mess of an image and get rid of it. And with everything selected, I'm going to round off the caps and the corners. There's the caps, and here are the corners. And last but not least, we have the live paint bucket tool. And with everything selected, first click on the graphic to make it a live paint group, and then choose your color from the color picker or the color panel. Click to add, and then we can, oh, that's a bit dark. Let's make that a bit lighter. Click again, there we go. One more bit of yellow, and we're done.